Allez. Right. After calculating, after discussing the calculation of borrowing cost for capitalization, so as I explained, we need to consider this criteria. Number one, the commencement of capitalization, I have already explained. The number three, number two, suspension of capitalization. Number three, right, cessation of capitalization, right. As I explained, the commencement of capitalization, the three activities should be satisfied, three criteria. You have to incur the expense for the qualifying asset, then you should be liable to pay interest cost and the, or borrowing cost, and you must start the physical activities of the qualifying asset. Then suspensions mean, so when you are capitalizing the borrowing cost on qualifying asset, sometimes according to the situation, according to the nature of that qualifying asset, you have to stop the capitalization for a temporary period, for a short period of time. So we call this a suspension of capitalization. For example, so after you taking taking the loan from bank, yes, after you sign the agreement with the bank, and if the money is credited to you, then you are liable to pay interest for the over the period. According to my previous example, that means 5 years period, you are liable to pay 50 million. Up to 31st December 2023, you want to pay interest. So then, during that construction period of that building, that means qualifying asset, sometimes for temporary period, you may have to stop the construction activity. Contractor may, due to bad weather condition, right? Due to like, for example, now you can take now recent good example because of this COVID-19, like this kind of effect. So we can't continue the construction activity. All activities are suspended, right? So the period also we don't know. If you take this kind of situation, so what happened? So you have started some construction activity, then you have borrowed the funds and you have invested on it. You are paying, you are liable to pay interest to the bank, but your construction activity you can't continue because of this kind of situation. So then what happened? Then then standard says what? Yes, because of some bad weather condition or sometimes some technical reasons, if you are not continuing the, if you are not carrying out the activities of that qualifying asset, that means the building construction, right? Yes, you can stop the capitalization for that period, right? Because you know that because of this the COVID-19, we have to stop normally all the activities at the middle of March. Still, we can't continue some activities, especially for the construction activity. There is a big impact to that industry. So then what happened? The people who has given the, who are carrying out the construction activity with the borrowed funds, yes, they are liable to pay interest, but their construction activity can't complete, difficult to carry out. Then during this period, so the, yes, accounting purpose, yes, you can stop the capitalization of that borrowing cost. Then that borrowing cost, if you have pay, you are liable to pay bank, that the borrowing cost incurred during that period, you can charge to the P&L without capitalizing. That is the meaning of suspension of the capitalization for a temporary period of time. So it says, entity shall suspend the capitalization of borrowing cost during the extended period in which the suspend active development of qualifying asset. Yes, if you can't carry out the activities of that qualifying asset, example for construction of building, yes, you have given one year period time, but because of some unexpected situation, we have to stop the activities. So we can't carry out the activities, then we can't achieve our expected completion date or level. So in that case, yes, for a temporary period, you can suspend the capitalization. Right. Then very important part is, like the first one, when you can start the capitalization, right? So then three condition satisfied. Now when you can cease the capitalization, when you can stop the capitalization, stop the capitalization, when you can stop the capitalization, you should know very clearly, right? Because you remember in my example, I raise a question for you, because according to now, I have already borrowed money 50 million from bank for 5 years time period. Then I am liable to pay interest on bank, right, for the borrowed funds, right? I liable to pay from 1st of January 2019 to 31st December 2023. That means 5 years time period. 5 years time period. But in case of qualifying asset, right, you know, the in my building, the construction period, you know that only 1 year. 1 year, right? It was start in 1st of April 2019, but complete, going to come, let's see, complete 2020, 31st March 2020 is only 1 year period, right? Now, yes, in case of my borrowed funds, yes, I liable to pay capital with interest up to 31st December 2003. But now this qualifying asset is completed and completed to my intended use. It was prepared for my required purpose on 31st March 2020. Now it is completed. Sometimes after 31st March 2020, I can use this building for my business purpose. But still I liable to pay interest after 31st December 2003. Right? Let's see, from 1st of April 2020 onward. Right? From 1st of April 2020. I, let's see, use this building for business activities. Let's see, right? What happened? Yes, this building construction completed on 31st March 2020. Now it is 100% complete. Yes, I can use this building for my business activity from 1st of April 2020 onward. Now I am using this building for my business activity. But the 50 million I used to complete this building as a borrowed funds, I am liable to pay interest up to 31st December 2023. Now what happened? The interest cost, borrowing cost that I have to incur after 1st of April 2020, what is the accounting treatment? Can you capitalize? Or any other accounting treatment? Or charge to P&L? Because now qualifying asset is up to my intended use. Now I am using my business purpose. Qualifying asset concept is completed, but still I am liable to pay interest to the bank. Then what happened, that interest cost that I have to incur after 1st of April 2020 up to 31st December 2023, right? What is the accounting treatment? Can I capitalize or charge to P&L? We will find the answer. Now, under the cessation of capitalization, it says, entity shall cease the capitalizing of borrowing cost when substantially all activities necessary to prepare qualifying asset for intended use or sale are complete. Yes. Then what happened? What is the answer for the cessation of capitalization according to my example? Yes, I must cease the capitalization. I should cease the capitalization. Cease capitalization on 31st March 2020. Yes, any borrowing cost incurred after 31st March 2020, I can't capitalize. Then what is the accounting treatment? Charged to P&L as a normal interest expense under the finance cost. Right? Then very clear, even though you have taken bank loan for a long period of time, but that the borrowing cost incurred on the capitalization, the qualifying asset, if the qualifying asset, that asset is completed completed according to your requirement, the any borrowing cost incurred after the after completing the qualifying asset, you must charge to the P&L. Right? It is very clearly mentioned, entity shall cease the capitalizing borrowing cost when substantially, underline, all activities are necessary to prepare the qualifying asset for intended use or sale or complete. Right? Then asset is normally ready for intended use or sale when physical construction of the asset is complete. And the second para, if I explain, it says about what? Yes, you know that in case of building, so it is very difficult to assess whether this building is complete 100% according to your requirement or not, because you know that, yes, physically in outside you can see, okay, this building is now complete. Yes, it is now completed building. But inside, there may be some minor activities still you want to carry out. Right? Sometimes even though it's outside, if it is completed, but inside, there are some minor activities you want to carry out. Some air condition you want to fix, some cleaning activities you want to do, or you have to fix some lights and other things. Right? So then it's still not completed. But the whether it completed or not is depend on what, if you can use it, either even though keeping some minor activities in the organization, in the building, right? So if you can carry out your business activity, so then we considered it as what come to your intended use, so say you intended use or sale. Right? So because sometimes the practical it is difficult to identify whether this building is completed 100% but standard says even though it subject to some minor activities also we can consider, yes, it is completed. So that's why it is very important to identify the cessation of capitalization is very important when that qualifying asset is completed to intended use or sale, then you have to stop the capitalization. Right? එතකොට මම මෙතන කතා කරේ අපි calculate කර borrowing cost අපි qualifying asset එකට capitalize කරන්න යනකොට අපිට ඒක කවදද පටන් ගන්න පුළුවන් කවදද ඒක ඉවර කරන්න ඕනේ කියලා clear understanding එකක් තියෙන්න ඕනේ. එතකොට මම මෙතන කතා කළා වගේ අපිට capitalization එක පටන් ගන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්නේ ඒ qualifying asset එකට වියදම් දරනකොට, ඒක physical activities කරගෙන යනකොට, සහ අපි ගත්ත ණය අපි ගත්ත බැංකු ලෝන් එකට ඉන්ටරස් ගෙවාගෙන යන්න අපි liable වෙන condition තුනම satisfy වුණාම තමයි අපිට borrowing cost එක qualifying asset එකේ capitalize කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්නේ. එතකොට ඒක කවදද අපි ඉවර කරන්නේ? මම මෙතන පෙන්නුවා වගේ ඔය අවුරුදු 5කට ලෝන් එකක් අරන් තියෙනවා. ඒකට 2023 වෙනකන් December 31 2023 වෙනකන් ඔයාට ඒ පොලී ගෙවන්න ඕනේ. ඒක completely pay කරන්න. හැබැයි ඔයාගේ qualifying asset එක building එක 2020 මාර්තු 31 වෙනකොට complete වෙලා ඉවරයි. හැබැයි 2030 2020 මාර්තු 31න් පස්සෙත් ඔයා මේ බිල්ඩින් එක වෙනුවෙන් ගත්ත මිලියන 50ට ණය ගෙවන්න ඕනේ ඉන්ට්‍රස් ගෙවන්න ඕනේ එතකොට ඒ ඉන්ට්‍රස් එකට මොකද කරන්නේ ඔයාට ඒත් කැපිටලයිස් කරන්න පුළුවන් බෑ එතකොට එතනදී පැහැදිලිව කියනවා ඒ ක්වොලිෆයින් ඇසෙට් එක ඔයාගේ ඉන්ටෙන්ඩඩ් යූස් එකට හෝ ඔයා නැවත විකිණීමට නම් හදන එක සේල් එකට කම්ප්ලීට් වුණායින් පස්සේ එතන ඉඳන් තව දුරටත් දරන ඉන්ට්‍රස් කෝස්ට් එක ඔයාට කැපිටලයිස් කරන්න බෑ ඒක නෝමලි PNL එකට චාර්ජ් කරන්න ෆයිනෑන්ස් එක්ස්පෙන්ස් එකක් විදියට පොලී වියදමක් විදියට ඒකයි මෙතන සරලව කිව්වේ එතකොට මෙතනදී කියනවා ඒ ඉන්ටෙන්ඩඩ් කම්ප්ලීෂන් එක ඔයා බලන්න ගියාම එතනදී ප්‍රැක්ටිකල් ප්‍රශ්නයක් ඒ අපිට පිටින් දැක්කාම බිල්ඩින් එක කම්ප්ලීට් තමයි නමුත් ඇතුලේ තව පොඩි පොඩි වැඩ කීපයක් තියෙන්න පුළුවන් නමුත් ස්ටෑන්ඩඩ් එකේ කියනවා එහෙම පොඩි පොඩි වැඩ කීපයක් තිබුණාට ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ සමහරවිට ඔය එයා කන්ඩිෂන් ෆික්ස් කරලා නැහැ ඉලෙක්ට්‍රික් වල ඉලෙක්ට්‍රික් රිලේටඩ් අයිටම්ස් වල වැඩ තියෙනවා නමුත් ඔයා ඒක ගොඩක් දුරට ඒක ඉවර නම් ඔයා බිස්නස් එක වාට කරගෙන යන්න තරම් පහසුකම් ඒක ඇතුලේ තියෙනවා නම් අපි හිතනවා ඒ බිල්ඩින් එක ෆෝ කැපිටලයිසේෂන් පර්පස් එකට කම්ප්ලීට් කියලා ක්වොලිෆයින් ඇසෙට් එක කම්ප්ලීට් කියලා. එතකොට ඒ කන්සෙප්ට් එක වැදගත් අපි කැපිටලයිස් කරන්න ගියාම. රයිට්. එතකොට රයිට්. So then that's why we discuss now the according to the LKS 23 if I summarize the areas again we discuss right first I discuss with you what is the meaning of borrowing cost is very important then I discuss capitalization what is the definition of qualifying asset then accounting treatment under the recognition I discuss it is the very important point then after that how to calculate the borrowing cost for the capitalization of qualifying asset then when you should start when you can cease that capitalization is an very important to understand that concept so if I again summarize this entire standard I can summarize into five or four questions yes what is the meaning of borrowing cost number 1 then what is the meaning of qualifying asset then what is the accounting treatment explained in this LKS 23 that is the most important thing standard says what any borrowing cost incurred to this qualifying asset yes can be capitalized on without charging to PNL as a interest expense yes you can add to the cost as a part of the cost of that qualifying asset if it is a qualifying asset only right that is the accounting treatment then you have to check whether these borrowed funds you have used for the qualifying asset is a 100% amount whether you have used or whether is that money taken from any common borrowing cost then if it is 100% loan if you have taken entirely for the qualifying asset we call it a specific borrowing then if you have not taken specific borrowing or if you have used funds from general funds taken from the company from outside parties then we call it a general borrowing right so then according to that situation you have to change your calculation then after that you have to think before you go into capitalize whether this entire three criteria should be satisfied or not you have to check under the commencement of this capitalization then as I explained you can decide when you should stop the capitalization on this borrowing cost on the qualifying asset the point is but when that qualifying asset come to your intended use or your requirement then you must stop the capitalization even though you are liable to pay interest to the bank that cost you can charge to the PNL right okay so then now we can discuss some few questions right according to the related to this LKS 23 I have given some very important questions for you yes number 1 question question number 2 the entity has following borrowing and used generally yes examiner says yes you have borrowed some funds and used generally is very important if you have used these funds generally mean it is not a specific borrowing is a general borrowing so then what are the information Examiner says about three loans, right? Loan number one, loan number two, loan number three. Then what is the loan amount? Loan amount rupees. This one, 5 million number one loan. Second loan, 12 million. Number third loan, only 3 million, right? You can take the total. Total is amount 20 million. Then what is the interest rate? Interest rate, we can identify. Interest rate given per annum, right? The first loan, 5 million you have taken for 22% per annum. Number two, 21% per annum. Number three, 20% per annum. Okay, it's a very good example for the general borrowing, right? Now it says what? Yes, entity has start to construct the showroom. Yes. Now why you have taken, yes, this loan to construct the showroom, and it was estimated that 12 months are required to finish it. Yes, only 12 month period. Estimated cost is 5 million. It is expected to be used for the loan which is entire has obtained. Entity has obtained. Calculate the capitalization rate and borrowing cost to be capitalized. Yes. Even though you have taken, now entity has taken 20 million under the three different sources as a borrowing cost. Entity has taken three borrowed funds, three type of borrowed funds. We can say, yes, these are the sources for borrowings. Number one, 5 million taken. Number two, 12 million taken. Number three, loan, 3 million taken. 20 million. But out of this 20 million funds, right, during 12 month, during 12 month period, right, we have used rupees 5 million only. For what purpose? To construct showroom. To construct showroom. Right. Now, you know that because this showroom you have to consider, yes, it's become a qualifying asset or not. Why? At the beginning of the 12 month period, let's see, at the beginning of the year, we will take the period also. Examiner not given the period, we will consider the period is 1st of January 2019 to 31st December 2019. Okay, is a 12 month period, right? This all loans you have taken at the beginning of the year, we will assume this all these loan you have taken in 1st of January 2019 up to subject to this interest rate per annum. Now the 1 year period, if you take 31st December 2019, then let's see, assume this showroom, the construction of this showroom also you have started in 1st of January 2019. Then but to complete period, the completion period also this showroom 12 month period. Then what is the total amount required? 5 million. Yes, out of this 20 million, you need only 5 million to complete this, right? So then it is very clear, you only need 5 million. Now this 5 million you are going to use out of this 20 million amount, right? There is no specific loan you have taken to complete this entire showroom. Time to time you have used this 5 million, you have taken this 5 million out of this 20 million. That's why we call this one is a general borrowing. Then you should identify before you go into answer to now examine asking what to calculate the capitalization rate. When you want to calculate the capitalization rate, only in case of general borrowing, right? Now the answer for the first question, you know that how to calculate the capitalization rate. Capitalization rate. Right. Capitalization rate mean is a weighted average of the borrowing cost. Then how you can calculate the weighted average cost of the borrowed funds? Yes. According to that formula, calculate first what is the borrowing cost incurred during twelve-month period. We will take borrowing cost incurred. Okay, borrowing cost incurred and total borrowed funds. Value of total borrowed funds. Total borrowing cost incurred, yes, you can calculate 5 million multiply 22% plus 12 million 21% plus 3 million multiply 20% per annum. Divide what is the total borrowed amount of the total borrowed funds, 5 million 12 plus 3. Right. Okay, this is the total interest cost you are liable to pay during this 12-month period. Right. Now calculate what is the total interest cost. Total interest cost mean borrowing cost incurred during the period. Number one, 1.1 million plus 2.52 plus 0.6 divide total 20 million, right? Now you can calculate what is the total interest cost incurred during the period. Right, 4.22 million plus divide 20 million multiply 100. Now we want to calculate the capitalization rate. Yes, what is the rate? 21.1% per annum. Right. For example, now you have calculated the weighted average cost of this borrowed funds is 21% per annum. The 21% 0.1 per annum, right? So that is the capitalization rate of this general borrowing, right? Now what is the second question? Borrowing cost to be capitalized. Yes, now we have calculated what is the capitalization rate here, 21.1%. Then how to calculate the borrowing cost that to be capitalized during the period? Yes, the borrowing cost to be capitalized on qualifying asset equal out of, now identify what is the amount used for this qualifying asset. Even though you have taken 20 million borrowed funds from the bank and other financial institution for this showroom, to construct this showroom is my qualifying asset, you have used only 5 million. Then take this 5 million amount and multiply this capitalization rate that you have calculated, right? Yes, amount is 1.055 million, right? 55 million. That means 1,055,000. This is the amount you should capitalize on the qualifying asset, right? So it's a very good example to practice in case of the general borrowing. Take this example number 2, right? This how to calculate the capitalization rate subject to this example, right? And also this is the way that capitalization rate you should calculate. Then finally, what is the amount we can capitalize on this borrowing cost. For example, if I take the journal entry for this 1 million, the borrowing cost you have capitalization, the calculated, the showroom is the asset we can debit. We will take like this. Showroom asset debit 1,055,000 and the cash O, yes, bank credit 1.05 million. This is the way you should record this journal entry, because without charging to P&L, now you can capitalize only 1,055,000 during the period. So it become a part of the cost of this showroom asset, right? Then if you have paid, cash or bank account can be credit. Or otherwise, if it is not paid as at 31st December, yes, you can identify as a payable amount, as a accrued interest payable, right? Another one, another example is the question number 3. So I want to mention here, so we want to identify another concept I can explain with this question number 3. First read the question. Entity start to construct 5-story building, right? That means, let's see, 5 floors with ground floor. There is a 5 floors, that means store building, and total cost has been finalized on 1st of July 2014. 2 stores were completed and used, right? Balance 3 stores were being constructing till 31st December 2014. The financial year ended is 31st December. Interest payment for the year 2014 were 24 million. Calculate the borrowing cost to be capitalized, right? It's a, another type of question that examiner can test from you. This related to this the borrowing cost capitalization, right? So according to the question, right, it says, yes, you are going to construct building with 5 stores. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, let's see, 5. Right. Now, period we will identify, we will assume 1st of January 2019 to 31st, sorry, period given 1st of January 2014 to 31st December 2014. Okay, right. Now it says entity start to construct the 5-story building and total cost has been finalized. Okay, total cost. What is the total cost of this building? Total cost of this building 24 million. Then construction period 1 year. Construction period 1 year. Construction period also the same period we can identify, 1st of January 2014 to 31st December 2014. Very clear. Okay, right. Then what it says, on 1st July 2014, 2 stores were completed. Yes, you have started. That means what happened? Out of this, you are starting to construct this building with the ground floor. Then let's see, this one is a ground floor, first and two. Yes, you have fully completed these 2 stores, the first and second one, during this period. That means first 6 month period, right? Starting from 1st of January 2014 to 30th June 2014. In first 6 month period, starting from 1st of January 2014 to 30th June, you have fully completed this first and second one. Then balance 3 store were construction till 31st December 2014. Yes, we can identify then this balance 3 was completed during this six-month period. That means starting from 1st of July 2014 to 31st December 2014. Okay? Right. Now, examiner asks him financial year ended 31st December, interest payment for the year 2014, 24 million. Okay. This is not the cost. Sorry. This is the total borrowing cost. Right? We don't know cost. Examiner not given the cost. Examiner given what? Total borrowing cost incurred. Total borrowing cost incurred rupees 24 million during this 12-month period. Okay. Examiner asking you to calculate what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized. What is the borrowing cost to be capitalized? Right. Now, yes. What is the impact now? Why this? Now, examiner says, yes. In this example, the first 6 months you have completed fully first 2 stores or floors. Now balance 3 you have completed in the second 6 month period. Right? Any impact to this? Answer is what? Now examiner asks him what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized. Sometimes you may answer entire 24 million, yes, we can capitalize. Yes. During the financial period, we have completed this entire building, right? Incurred total borrowing cost 24 million for this purpose, right? And now we want to check now whether this entire 24 million we can capitalize or not. Yes. According to the information we discuss up to now, yes, you may answer, yes, entire 24 million we can capitalize. But what happened? There is another thing you to understand, right? When you are going to complete qualifying asset step by step, then entire you want to make some adjustment to the entire borrowing cost you incurred during the period on this qualifying asset. That's why examiner has highlighted this point here. Examiner says, even though you have incurred 24 million entire the borrowing cost or interest cost to complete this building, this 1 year period, the you have completed within 6 months the first and second floor of this building, but third and fourth and fifth you have completed in next 6 month period. Now we want to check whether this information has any impact on this 24 million or not. එතකොට අපි දන්නවා දැන් ඇත්තටම මේ බිල්ඩින් එක තට්ටු පහක බිල්ඩින් එකක්. ඉතින් මේ බිල්ඩින් එක වෙනුවෙන් තමයි මේ 2014 අවුරුද්දේ මේ 24 million ඉන්ක කරලා තියෙන්නේ borrowing cost. එතකොට අපි දැන්ට කතා කරපු විදිහට එහෙනම් මේකට අහන්න ඕන ප්‍රශ්නිකුත් නෙවෙයි මේ මිලියන 24ම yes we can capitalize. හැබැයි එක්සැමිනර් කියනවා තව දෙයක්. ඔව් මේ මිලියන 24 borrowing cost we have incurred ඒක හරි. හැබැයි යා කියනවා පළවෙනි ෆ්ලෝ දෙක අපි ඉවර කරා 6 month එකෙන් ඒක full complete. එතකොට මේ දෙක ඉවරයි සමහරවිට මේ දෙකේ වැඩ මේ දෙක පාවිච්චි කරන ගමන් ඉතුරු තුන හදලා දෙනවා. ඉතුරු තුන ඊළඟ මාස 6 න් ඉවරයි. එතකොට මේ මුල් ෆ්ලෝ දෙක ඉවර කරලා ඉතුරු තුන ඉවර කරන් ඉවර ඒ දෙක පාවිච්චි කරන ගමන් ඉතුරු තුන කළා නම් ඒ ইনফরমේෂන් එකේ ඉම්පැක්ට් එකක් තියනවද මේ 24 million වල. So that is the thing we want to discuss. Yes. Answer is what? Yes, there is an impact. If the examiner says your qualifying asset is you have completed step by step, after completing the first part, if you are while using that part, if you are continuing the balance part, then that impact you must adjust to the total borrowing cost incurred during that period. Where that examiner says that point, please come to the TUT. After the point I have highlighted here, the borrowing cost, the cessation under the cessation of capitalization of borrowing cost, the last paragraph I have mentioned. Can you see the last para in the under the cessation of capitalization? When entity complete the construction of qualifying asset in parts, yes, in parts, and each part is capable of being used while construction continuing on other part. Can you see now this example? You can clearly understand. Yes, what happened? Yes, first this entire construction period is 12 month period, but within first 6 month period you have completed first and second part. Now after completing, while you are using this first and second part, next 6 month period you have completed third and fourth, fifth one. Then what is the impact to the calculation? It says the entity shall cease the capitalizing of the borrowing cost when it completes substantially all the activities of the necessary to compare the part for the intended use or sale. Underline the word, entity shall cease the capitalizing of borrowing cost when it completes substantially all the activities. Yes. Now this what is the impact of that information for this question? Yes, you can't capitalize now entire 24 million as a borrowing cost to the qualifying asset. Yes, what happened? First 2 month, 6 month period, yes, you must identify what is the total borrowing cost out of this 24 million for this first 6 month period. That amount you can capitalize without any adjustment because you are incurring cost for entire building. But the second 6 month period you want to make some adjustment. Why? Because the part of this first and second floor it has already completed, right? Out of 5, 2 completed, only 3 continuing, 3 parts continuing in the last 6 month period. Then that impact you must adjust to this borrowing cost amount, the total borrowing cost incurred during the period. So then how to answer for this question? You should identify here the first, we should identify the borrowing cost incurred. This is the answer you want to calculate. Right. First, we should identify what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized during first 6 months. That means 1st of January 2014 to 30th June 2014. How you can calculate? Take 24 million amount out of 12, 6 month period we can identify. So then answer is what? Yes, take half, 50% based on the period, it's an 12 million, right? Is the 12 million amount. Then identify what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized during last 6 month period. Last 6 month period, that means first of July 2014 to 31st December 2014, right? Then how you can make the adjustment? Take out of this total borrowing cost, take half. That means again you want to do the 6 month period, 12 divided 6, right? Only 6 month. Then you know that then answer is again coming the balance amount 12 million, but you want to take now this adjustment. The last 6 month period you have incurred the borrowing cost on this building, right? After 100% completing this first and second floor only, right? During this last 6 month period, actually you have done the activities, right? Only for third and fourth and fifth floor only, right? That means from 1st of July 2014 onward, right? You are doing the construction, you have done the construction activity only for five third parts only. That means third stores only, right? Only three stores. First and two already complete. Then take that adjustment to here, right? Then how you can find, how you can do that adjustment? Take only five third. Because in last 6 month period, we have continued the activity only for three stores, right? So because of that adjustment, now you can calculate what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized for the last 6 month period. That means 7.2 million, right? Then total borrowing cost to be capitalized, what is the answer? 19.2 million, right? This is the answer for capitalization. Now you can see, because of this partly completion of this qualifying asset, right? Not entire 24 million is the borrowing cost to be capitalized. It now that amount has adjusted up to 19.2 million amount, right? Because of this adjustment, right? This is the way you want to answer if the examiner tested. If the qualifying asset you are going to complete as a partly completion, right? So then if any part of that qualifying asset is completed, we have to stop the capitalization for that first two part, then only balance parts only we want to identify the borrowing cost for the capitalization. So that is the idea I have given under the cessation of capitalization in the third para, right? Okay, right. So according to that, then we can do some past paper questions. So we can identify what are the past paper questions related to this borrowing cost, right? Right. Come to the 2017 July, question number 3. 2017 July, question number 3. A part. The first past paper question we are going to discuss under the LKS 23 borrowing cost is question number 3, A part, right? Right. It's a simple question for 2 marks. Define the qualifying asset as per LKS 23. Define qualifying asset as per LKS 23. That's why I told you when I discussed the LKS 23, the definition of qualifying asset is very important, right? Very important, because that is the key word in LKS 23 explained. So then what is the qualifying asset as we discuss, right? Qualifying asset is an asset, and you answer these words are very important. That will necessarily take time to complete. It will take necessary for a considerable time period for get ready for intended use or sale. Because qualifying asset, always we are not using, we are not constructing or producing or acquiring only for the administration purpose or usage. It can be what? For resale purpose also we can identify qualifying asset. That's why I have taken inventory is also part of the example, is a example for the qualifying asset. So then I have given the in my tut I have given the definition of qualifying asset, right? So please apply that, use that definition to answer this question. The qualifying asset is again an asset, so it will necessarily take for a considerable period of time to get ready for intended use or sale, right? Then next question, 2018 January, question number 2. 2018 January, question number 2. Yes. Sorry, 2018 January, question number 5B. Question number 5B. The next question is 2018 January, question 5B. Question number 5B. Right. This question says about, yes. First, read the question. Identify the answer. It's a simple question under the LKS 23. Right. ABC company has obtained a bank loan of 20 million on 1st January 2016 at the interest rate of 15% per annum. Right? To construct manufacturing plant. The construction of the manufacturing plant has been started on 1st May 2016. Right? 1st May 2016. And complete on 31st March 2017. Right. The unused amount of bank loan was temporarily invested and earned an interest income 300,000 during the year ended 31st March 2017. You are required to compute the borrowing cost could be capitalized on the new manufacturing plant as at 31st March 2017. Right. Now, any question that examiner tested, the examiner test, you should be able to answer. You know that when you are going to calculate the borrowing cost for capitalization, only two type, only two method you can apply. Either that question should related to specific borrowing, or it should be related to general borrowing. Then in case of specific borrowing, mean you know that the loan is specific, only entire borrowed funds you are 100% using for qualifying asset. Normally that funds you have borrowed only in one place, only one source, right? But 100% that funds you use for the qualifying asset with a particular interest rate. Then sometimes out of that money, if you temporarily invested during that construction period, right, you may earn some additional interest income. Then you know that why examiner has given here, you have earned some unused money, you have invested, and there is an interest income. Right? Why examiner says? Because this question is now related to specific borrowing. So if you identify that point, it is very easy you to answer this question. Right? Okay. First, identify the period mentioned here. The financial period here, 1st of April 2016 to 31st March 2017. It's important to identify the period. Now, has obtained the bank loan of 20 million on 1st of April 2016 at the interest rate of 15%. Yes, you have taken bank loan 20 million on 1st of April 2016, right? Interest rate 15% per annum. 15% per annum. The construction of the manufacturing plant has been started on 1st May 2016 and complete on 31st March 2017. But now, why you have taken this loan? You have taken this loan to construct manufacturing plant. Okay? So this plant start activities, we can say activities and expense, even though you have taken this loan on 1st of April 2016, the start activities and expenses, right, on 1st of May 2016 onward, right? Okay. So then what happened? It was completed and completed on 31st March 2017, right? So the construction period, the construction period How many month? Only 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 8 and yes, only first 4 months we have not considered. So then during this 12 month period, yes, after 1 month period you have start this activity. So then only 11 month period use for the construction purpose, right? Because you have started in 1st of May, it was completed in 31st March 2017. But financial period started from 1st of April 2016. Then this entire construction period taken for only 11 month period. But the loan you have taken for 1st of April 2016, that means entire 12 month period you are liable to pay interest. Right, you are liable to pay interest. Then after you take in the loan, that unused amount, because even though you have taken 20 million, right, this entire 20 million you are not paying at once to the contractor, right? So you are paying the amount time to time, you are paying to the contractor. So therefore what happened, always there is unused amount, balance amount with you. So it better you invest in another investment opportunity and earn some temporary investment income. So like that, here also you says unused amount, the examiner says unused amount of the bank loan was temporary invested and earned 300,000. Now what is the requirement? Borrowing cost to be capitalized for the new manufacturing plant we want to calculate. Now the when you are going to calculate the borrowing cost to be capitalized, answer, borrowing cost to be capitalized, the period you should identify, you know that the borrowing cost you can't calculate for capitalization period for entire 12 month period. Because you know that I discussed with you the commencement of capitalization, the commencement of the capitalization of borrowing cost on qualifying asset, the three activities should be satisfied. Number one, you are liable to incur the borrowing cost on borrowed funds, you are liable to pay interest on the borrowed funds, number one. Number two, you have to incur expenses on that qualifying asset, and you have to do the physical activity of the construction of that qualifying asset. All these three activities satisfied only, you can start the capitalization of borrowing cost. Now, here also you can see, even though you have taken loan from the bank in 1st of April 2016, right? But the construction activity with expense that contractor has started on 1st of May 2016. So then entire 12 month period, you can't calculate the borrowing cost for capitalization purpose. So then you have to adjust that amount for the 11 month period. So then take borrowed amount and multiply 15% per annum and should adjust it with 11 month period, right? Not for entire 12 month period. So then what is the amount to be capitalized? Yes, 2,070,000. We can say 2 million, 2 point, right, 2,750,000, right? So then you can deduct temporary, you have earned temporary investment income during the period. That temporary investment income also you should deduct, right? So then answer is 2,450,000, right? This is the answer for the borrowing cost to be capitalized during the period. Because this is the most important point you have to consider, because in this question examiner tested that commencement of capitalization part also. So otherwise, if you take for entire 12 month period, the amount is not correct. And also you know that in case of a specific borrowing, right, the temporary investment income you must deduct, then only the net borrowing cost you can identify for the capitalization, right? Right, another question we can discuss, 2016 January, question number 2, 2016 January, question number 2, again there is a question to calculate the amount to be capitalized as a borrowing cost, right, 2016 January, question number 2. Question number 2. Please read the question. Okay, question number 2, ABC Limited has obtained the following loan from PQ Bank during the year ended 31st December 2015. Okay, so ABC Limited has taken three loans. You can see loan numbers given, date of loan given, right? Not in the same date, in a different dates you have, the company has taken loan, loan amount given, and interest rate per annum also given, right? On 1st June 2015, ABC Limited has started to construct a new plant, and it is expected to finish the construction activity by 30th September 2016. Right, 30th September 2016. On completion, the plant will cost 15 million. Right. The board of directors of the company has decided to fund this investment of constructing of the plant using the loan obtained during the year ended 31st December 2015. Compute the amount to be capitalized as a borrowing cost. Right. This question, you can see again what happened. The three loans information given, right? So if you calculated the total loan value, 7, 8, 10, that means total 25 million. But to complete this plant, the plant cost is 15 million. Right, so then again this question is related to what? General borrowing. Right, then you know what is the approach for the general borrowing. You have to calculate capitalization rate, that means weighted average amount of the borrowing cost. Right, use the approach for the general borrowing. Right, so then I will take here the loan information with the loan date. Right, the number of loan. Right, number I will take as a number 1, number 2 and 3, then the date of loan. Right, the first loan it has taken 1st of January 2015. Right, 1st of January 2015. Then second one, 15th March 2015, and 30th April 2015. Right, so then loan amount, loan amount 7 million, 8 million, and 10 million. Total, take 25 million. Right? Total loan, 25 million. Right? Interest rate, interest rate 12, 15, and 11. Right. Okay. So then on 1st of June 2015 ABC Limited has started to construct the new plant, and it was expected to finish of the construction activity by 30th September 2016. Right. The loan you have taken in the different dates is okay, but you have started the construction activity of the plant in 1st of June 2015. And other thing you should consider, this entire loan, the last loan you have taken is this, out of this all loan is 10 million. Right. It was taken in 30th April 2015. Right, but now after taking these all loans, that mean entire three loans, you have started the construction activity of this plant. Right, that is the point you want to consider. Right, the date of this completion is 1st of January 2015. Now let's see, this is the plant. Right, right, plant, the construction start 1st June 2015, right, and complete 30th September. So it will take the total time period to complete this entire plant is you can see in the 1 year and June, July, August, September. That mean total period is 15 months, right? 15 months. So June, because 1st of June 2015 to 30th June 2016, then July, August, and September, right? So then on completion, the plant will cost is 15 million. So what is the total cost of this plant? The total cost, now not the borrowing cost, total cost you have incurred 15 million. Okay, 15 million cost. The board of directors of the company has decided to fund this investment of the construction of plant using the loan obtained during this year ended 31st December 2015. Okay, year end period is 31st December 2015. Compute the amount to be capitalized for the borrowing cost. Right, now this borrowing cost to be capitalized amount we should calculate related to period. Okay, now information given, we have taken loan in the starting from 1st of January 2015 and 31st March 2000, the second one we have taken 50th March 2015, then next one at the end of the April month, right? So then our financial period we should consider here. The financial period is financial period for this question is 1st of January 2015 to 31st December 2015. Okay, 12 month period, right? But this plant going to complete in next year after 9 month period, right? Now examiner asking what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized during this as at the end of the 31st December 2015. Okay, right. Now you can understand the total borrowed funds amount is 25 million. Total borrowed funds amount is 25 million. Out of this 25 million, we have used 15 million. Okay, this is the general borrowing, right? General borrowing. So then you know that first you have to calculate what is the capitalization rate, right? Capitalization rate. Then you know what is the formula. First you have to calculate what is the borrowing cost incurred divide total amount of borrowings, right? Now what is the borrowing cost incurred during the period? Number one, this is the weighted average amount of weighted average rate of borrowed funds, 7 million multiply 12% plus 8 million multiply 15% plus 10 million multiply 11% plus, right? 11%. So then total borrowed funds we can identify 25 million, right? So then identify what is the total interest cost during the period. Right, 12.5 is the capitalization rate. Now we should identify out of this 12.5, so this is the capital, this is the common rate we should apply for the to identify the borrowing cost to be capitalized. Then we can calculate the borrowing cost to be capitalize equal, what is the total amount used during the period, right? The 15 million. So we don't know what is the 15 million, the time gap we should identify. So if you are considering entire 15 million, we can apply amount used 12.5%. Now amount is, the borrowing cost to be capitalized, 1,884,000. 1,884,000, right? But now you may ask, now examiner asking only amount to be capitalized as a borrowing cost. This examiner not asking what is the borrowing cost capitalized as at 31st December 2015. Okay, so if the examiner asking, if the examiner asking the what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized as during the financial period 2015, then examiner should provide what is the amount used as at the 31st December 2015 out of this 15 million, because examiner says the total 15 million, the on completion the plant will cost 15 million on completion, right? The board of directors has decided to use the investment one, because now examiner asking what is the total borrowing cost to be capitalized related to this qualifying asset plan, right? Examiner not asking what is the borrowing cost to be capitalized as at the end of the 31st December 2050, because we don't know. Then to find that answer, examiner must provide out of this 15 million what is the total cost incurred at the end of the 31st December 2050, right? So therefore here we have calculated, yes, out of this 25 million we have used 15 million amount subject to 12.5% interest per annum, right? So therefore total borrowing cost you can capitalize on this plant is 1,884,000. 84,000, right? Now okay, now these are the past paper questions we can discuss related to qualifying asset and borrowing cost, right? Now 2019 July we can't see any question related to borrowing cost. Then we can expect in this time sometimes examiner can test, examiner can include the question from borrowing cost, right, in your paper. So therefore very important to understand this knowledge and this one, and we can see some adjustments also in your company final account question also, because borrowing cost always is a very common standard we are using in accounting, because you know that all entities, they are borrowing funds for their business activities. So, but here the problem is, yes, even though you have borrowed the fund from the bank, then that money you must use for what? Qualifying asset only for the capitalization purpose. So then any other borrowing cost you have, you incurred during the period related to borrowed funds from bank or another financial institution, you have to apply normal general accounting treatment. That means always charged to the P&L as a finance expenses, right? So that is the thing you should understand, right? So then the borrowing cost, as I explained, we can summarize again finally, but you should know the what is the borrowing cost, what is the qualifying asset mean, then what is the recognition criteria given this standard, right? Then after that, how to calculate the borrowing cost for the capitalization purpose. Again, two methods, specific borrowing and general borrowing. Then what are the conditions to be satisfied to start the capitalization? Then what is the condition should satisfied for the cessation of capitalization? Those are the areas you should know in relation to the qualifying asset under LKS 23. And if you analyze the past paper question, that's why I discussed some four, five questions I discussed with you. Now, out of these all questions, examiner has tested, but most of the time examiner testing what? General borrowing. The question related to the general borrowing to calculate the capitalization rate and what is the amount to be capitalized for the unqualifying asset. So therefore, you have to consider that point also when you are going to study and for the examination purpose, this LKS 23. Okay.